Outside of the bullpen, Danny Coulomb. So he picked up one. And
Larry Vanover, rather.
One in the Jorge Lopez deal. Now, to be fair to Minnesota, you could say, boy, but last year, too.
Yeah, it's not like Cano was having a lot of success as a Twin right. either.
And that's been the strength. It's a four pitch walk to Margot. That was very un Danny like.
Only four. All three inside to Austin Martin. To right, down the line, slicing foul off the net. Runner goes, 3-2 pitch, line drive, base hit left center field. Margot to third base. He's got the green light from Tommy Watkins. Henderson fires way offline. Oh and two. Down and inside. Trying to go to third base. And Castro can't hold up on the changeup. It's popped up, and that will get foul as the sun is trying to. Would likely come in next. 2-2. Line drive, base hit, left field. Martin, great speed around third, heading home. The throw will not be in time. Martin scores, Twins tick. Baltimore changes up its hitting plans. Austin Hayes off the bench, first pitch, pops it up to center. And Martin will make the catch. Trouble. Left center field, hit a ton, tie game. Birdbath responds, and this is a 2-2 game. Walker's righties as well, but so all that work for the Twins to get back in luck out seven. 2-1.
Make an argument that's his best start of the year.
And was able to do something that his team
runs across the board.
There's the Twins dugout. Ryan Mountcastle last 2-2. We'll do it again. Ball three outside, and there's so many good numbers about the Twins pitching this year as a team.
It's hard to think about silver linings with the way it's gone so far, but that will regress. It's the
lengthy battle here again. The 3-2 pitch, and that's pulled foul.
So you know from what we've witnessed this year.
Line drive, left center field, Margot plays this out of bounds. And Mountcastle, this season, 1-for-13. As he spins in, a breaking ball there to even up the count.
26
has bounced out and struck out today. 1-2. Struck him out on a fastball towards the outside corner. Tied for third most in the American League. Mountcastle runs. And this is popped up to shallow center. Castro out. Martin coming in. It's going to land. Holding it. Now we got a piece. The 1-1. Added in. Fouled it off. Runner at first goes. The pitch is high and no throw down to second base. Good foul. Out. Stewart needs one more strike. Sinker in, and again Jeffers down. Again the 2-2. Struck him out at 97. And the Kowser moves to right. Hayes after batting for O'Hearn stays in. And now he kind of stings Adley Rutschman. Cano an all-star last year. Jeffers, ground ball to third. Westberg on the charge. For him was a valuable setup man for Felix Bautista.
I remember.
Change up low on Buxton. Byron 0 for 3 today. That'll play. Two-two, and Buxton strikes out. Sinker disappears inside and down. The lefty Kirilov can get on here.
There.
Rutschman sets up, down and away. Full count. And Kirilov got a piece of that changeup. Low ball four, good take. So Kirilov with a nice plate appearance here in the eighth inning. You're not looking for a sinker in that look. Now the 1-2 pitch, and that one pops away from Rutschman. Off a two-out walk. As Cano throws over. Miranda could not hold back on a slider. And Cano opens. Holiday 0 for 2. And now behind, two quick strikes. Strike 3, 98, and down goes Holiday. Run, two strikeouts. Up the middle and into center field, a base hit. 0 for 3. Ball one high. You being a three-time All-Star closer.
Yeah, and it's funny because it's probably arguably more important to be holding runners.
Popped up weakly. Near third, Farmer has plenty of room, two down. Austin Hayes. His second at bat, and a strike. I asked Brock Stewart in spring training.
Be able to focus more on the hitter than the base runner. If your focus leaves, if you're worrying about that guy in first base, you're not going to be able to execute your pitch.
And the Twins, what they add, two of those three boxes, that's what they asked their relievers to do. And right now, Brock Stewart, he was focused. Margot leads off. He walked and scored in the seventh, and Kimbrel strike. I'll get foul. And Margot got a piece of that curveball. Could not hold off the curveball this time. A great game offensively, defensively. Doesn't chase, ball one outside. A Farmer, seventh inning, base hit. Showing discipline here, not chasing as Margot was on pitches off the corner.
Further and further out.
And that is painted.
Comes out low, stays low.
Or three.
Hot.
Fly ball to left, shallow. Austin Hayes makes the line to first, but right at Mountcastle. Castle's had a couple of good stand in the ninth inning as Griffin Jacks is on to try and force a tenth.
Hasn't paid.
There is 1 for 3. Strike one. And 96. As he misses high. Foul back.
Justin will see if he goes back and tries to bury it.
Instead with the gas, and Santander had no chance. 97. And now Ryan Mountcastle. Starter for a while. And this is a base hit to left center field. Martin better hurry. Mountcastle's going to round and hold.
And that's what we've seen from Griffin Jacks. He's maintained the command. Maintain the ability.
Well, Mullins swings and misses on a changeup.
And the question, we've seen that pitch mix.
Popped up left field, shallow, slicing foul. Farmer giving chase, that'll land.
Seen that pitch mix come into play time in any count.
Mullins sends it high and deep to right field. Kirilloff back. He'll turn to the wall. Cedric Mullins, game-winning home run. The first swing and the final swing for Baltimore today. Home runs, and the Orioles sweep the Twins 4-2 in walk-off fashion today.
They had a lead late in this one, and the Twins bullpen has been